the 44 King. He's blowing steam, dropping a load of water here.
First 3 seconds, because it takes a little bit of time to build up enough pressure to get in the boiler. So before it's got enough pressure, it has to go somewhere, so it dumps out on the ground. And if something is a little bit finicky, if it doesn't work, then it'll just spray out.
This so, is kind of like a safety too, isn't it?
Well, not really.
No?
No.
Boy, we're glad to see this. I'm a local internet TV station. I'll give you a card for those guys.
How does this compare in horsepower?
Okay.
So you got electrical, you got diesel, then electrical, and motors on the wheels.
Okay.
So those are a lot more. There's, you know, these are very deep machines. Great historic value.
Right.
There's
but
no
there's
competition.
A reason it evolved past that.
There's no competition for the diesel. Okay. Not even close.
Here's our card, sir. We're an internet television station here in Tucson. We show all these events, and we've done the Transportation Museum. What is your role here? Are you a fireman or a brakeman? Or what?
No, I'm do mostly the water treatment. Fill up the tenders, do the casting and chemical treatment, and everybody on the crew does everything they need, whatever needs to be done.
Now, does that tender carry the water and the...
Water and fuel oil.
And the fuel oil, I see. Well, thank you very much from KRAZ-TV.
Well, folks, there it is.
What a great idea. Hey, we got a little interview from 4014, and he's the water tender guy. He said they all do the duty, so, you know, they're just lapping up and hamming it up here for KRAZ-TV and Tucson, this historic moment in Tucson, the world's largest steam locomotive operational, rebuilt by Union Pacific. See you, keep watching. I knew you were. Well, I'm talking to a guy, we ain't showing his face, but he said this was 1.2 million pounds, 6,000 to 7,000 horsepower, but here it is. There's who it is, preserved by the Railroad and Locomotive Historical Society, Southern California chapter at Rail Giants Train Museum, Los Angeles County Fairplex, Pomona, California, from January 62 to June of 2013. Wow, it took them a long time. So, hey, we've just had a little interview and talk, and so now it'll be a slideshow.
She keeps telling me.
And here we are. Well, folks, we want to say thank you to the Arizona Rangers, Arizona's finest. Yep, they're down here. Making sure we're safe. You got to stay out of that steam blow, because they're keeping the boiler built up. But this thing will pull this entire train, and it weighs 1.2 million pounds, I guess this, and the tender also. 7,000 horsepower by a crankshaft. These are not electric motors in the wheels. But we will go down and show you a modern locomotive. Uh-oh, there goes a blow again. So it's UP-814, Jim Adams. I wonder what these names are of all these folks. Wow, this is 2551, Building America, baby, Union Pacific. That's a good looking shot. Well, there it is, folks. We got mail cars, we got the Lockman. Wow, what a lucky thing. Well, we'll go by and see if, what they say here. Maybe we'll find out who these names are. But here's 1671 is not going to be left out. Ring that bell again! There it is, folks. These are folks here. Oh, I can't believe it. They're letting kids pull on the cord. We'll talk to this guy. It's getting ready to go, folks. Wow, this is exciting. They're getting ready to go. So we'll see you up the road. Okay, they're getting ready to clear track here, so we're going to be pulling ahead. Terry ZTV will be right back. Okay, those guys said they're getting busy, so they got to take off. But these names on these cars right here. So Joe Jordan, we want to thank you, and you've been honored on this great tour, this great American tour of the world's largest operational steam locomotive for Union Pacific. And Carrie ZTV, this is Doc Martin saying thank you. Yes, we're going to be taking off. It's ready to. Now they're getting ready to pull out, so we have to stay back 25 feet because the steam may blow out that far. So he's keeping us back.
Is this it? Is this like the line?
Well, he said it has to be back this far. So they're getting ready to move, folks. Craze TV is going to stay till the last bitter moment. They got 5 seconds, a couple minutes. They got a guy going up. Did he get it? Did he get Papa in there? You want me to take a picture of you and him together?
Yes, sir.
No. So, wow. So we got all these folks here. This guy's getting ready to take out 4014, a 4884, 168. Wow. We're going to take out down here. So we're going to go down through here. They're getting ready to move, folks. Yeah. Stay safe, folks. Stay off the tracks if you don't have to be on them. Well, this is the K-9 unit, the police, and probably the news people sitting here. So this will be where they bring the exit will go south through here. So KRAZ-TV watching the train come to town. It'll never happen again in my lifetime. Of course, this is Union Pacific Railroad officer. Hello, KRAZ-TV, Arizona's finest. Okay, folks.
Oh no! Of us watching it and it going by. What are they doing?
These guys just a little bit.
All right, sit back.
Here, right here, a little bit more.
Hey, it's Bill and Stan. Got it. Ready to go. There it goes. Woo! Throwing a lot of power out right there. It's actually under its way powered now. 4014 coming through Tucson. Thank you. folks here. There's the engineer of that train. Bye bye, big boy.
Thank you.
There's the conductor. There it is, folks. Experience the Union Pacific. So we're coming up close to the end of this special exhibit of the big boy 4014 coming through Tucson. Oh, there's a coach, there's people and dignitaries up there, there's a club car, food, and the last car, no more caboose. Remember the caboose? There it is, goodbye.
Oh, here comes another one. Toot toot.
Folks, we want to thank you for coming down here and viewing with us in Tucson. That's right, KRZ-TV showing the departure of the 4014, the world's largest steam locomotive operational for Union Pacific and Amtrak in Tucson and the Transportation Museum. Thanks for watching. One more footage from Union Pacific. Now this is not 4014, but it is a train. Look at all the graffiti art on it. Train, folks, but we weren't too late to catch it. Thanks for watching Crazy TV.
Well, here's folks. I'm giving, are you with the Transportation Museum or are you with the railroad?
I'm with the museum, but I'm a retired railroad conductor.
Well, you get joint rights for this. Here's our card. You've been interviewed. We already have a museum tour, so thank you. Operation Red Block and
Operation
folks,
Red Block.
What it is,
Red Block is a drug and alcohol volunteers. So we're, but Operation Lifesaver, now that's where
That's what I wanted to say, I see.
Operation
okay.
Lifesaver, that's where we go out into the public and we teach people how not to get hit by trains.
Don't cross when those dropped arms come down. Don't try to beat the phone.
Don't play on the railroad.
Don't try on the phone. Well, folks, here we are with these folks here at the transportation, and we want to let you know you guys have joint rights on this film. So they can just go download it, and everything we've got for Big Boy and 4014 for KRAZ-TV belongs to this gentleman and all the people at the Transportation Museum, and we're making that a public notice here. Thank you, and thank you for giving your permission. Goodbye. Well, Doc Martin here, and we're in the public art. Remember this public art. We're parked down here. So we're going along with the Tool Avenue art and murals, and there's a train mural we haven't seen. This is the Warehouse Arts District here, and there's their QR code if you want it. Well, thanks for watching in Operation Lifesaver. That's the campaign by the railroad for people to get watch out for trains and don't cross those arms when they're down and come again. Now tomorrow, Big Boy's gonna be on display near 29th and Ferguson. So we'll see if I can go down there. And that's my brother's birthday. So we're dedicating this to my brother, Mark Martin. Goodbye and from, see you, KRZ TV.